Yo, yo, what's up, Facebook, Instagram? This is your boy Elijah Efron, right? Just wanted to drop a quick video this morning. I felt led to do so. Seemed like this angle is a little bit better. Finally got out that sun. That sun was beaming down, but I love the sun though. So anyway, I just want to drop a quick video. I got a few minutes to holler at the people. Thank goodness for the people that listen. I'm grateful for the people that I listen to. I'm gonna just jump straight into it. The worst thing that you can do to a human being on the planet is tell them to act dead when they're still alive. And what I mean by that is I was talking to my partner, and he was telling me that he feel like he's a little bit too old to do something, or his kids are too young to be put into this. Or be put into that. So we were talking on that level. What came to my mind was this. Everything is done by faith. Every single thing that we do is done by faith. You write a book by faith, and which means the hope is that someone go out and purchase it. You don't know exactly what the book is going to do at the time. You present a movie. You wrote a script. By faith, you hope that someone picks it up and it becomes a big motion picture. You have children who call themselves young, and I hope to get old one day, but even all that is by faith. The people that are calling you and name calling you and telling you you're young or you old or whatever, what have you, their whole life is on a faith system. We all move and live by faith. That's the whole concept to life. Everything that we do is done by faith. So, with that being said, no one can judge you. If you're still living and you know who you are, and this video is for you, if you're still living on the planet that we called Earth, you don't let nobody determine the moves you make. Let me tell you some of the ages of some of the guys that I work with. Brother Fred, what's up? How you doing? That's my god pop. He's over my dad's age. I don't know his age because, we don't even discuss it. But he still plays full court basketball. He's in perfect shape. Went to the doctor. He said that his blood pressure, his cholesterol, his sugar, everything was in good shape. And the doctor looked at him like, "What are you doing?" But then you can have a 17-year-old kid go to the doctor and he's got high blood pressure and sugar diabetes, things of that nature. It's all about how you take care of your body. You know what I mean? James, he's not, James is about at least 75. What's up, James? James is about at least 75, 76 years old, but he's one of the coldest writers that I know. You understand what I'm saying? James is one of the coldest writers that I know. This dude wrote a poem and had me in tears. I cried days later. I was going through something and I cried days later because of the words that this dude said in this poem. He's an awesome writer. He's about 70. James is about 75, 76 now. So what I'm trying to tell you, my point is that we never, ever stop living while we're alive. That gift that God has put in you is going to haunt you. You're going to have to follow it. You're going to have to do what it's requiring you to do. You know what I'm saying? You're going to have to do it. Like now, me, I'm writing a book. I decided to chill. I'm writing a book. I have a lot to write about. I've been through a lot. It don't seem like it. It don't look like it. But a lot of us have. And all we want to do is relate to each other, relate to one another. You know what I'm saying? So this is what the videos, and this is why we do what we do. We do it all by faith. I promise you it's by faith. Even this video is by faith. Somebody's going to hear it. Somebody's going to shun it. But it's going to get to the right person. And they say there's 7 billion people on the planet. So it's easy for something to go platinum. It's easy for something to sell 1 million copies, 2, 3 million copies, because that many people on the planet can relate to what you've been through and what you've gone through. I remember this. I'm gonna give this little testimony. There's a difference between I don't have some lady said you shouldn't tell your personal business. I don't have any personal business. My life is in a book. You know what I mean? My life is a testimony. We gotta learn how to separate a testimony for your personal business. I don't have any personal business. My life is out there. You know what I mean? with the protection and the grace of God connected to it. Prosperity, love, gentleness, patience, kindness, it's all connected. You know, we got a lot of work to do. We got to work on ourselves. You know, we made mistakes in life and all of that good stuff. But let me tell you, let me give you this little testimony real quick. This is leading somewhere. I don't know where, but I feel led to say this. I remember a while ago, about six months. And Fred, you know about this. God will always have somebody walk through you through a journey that you know, like, why am I going through this? You working and everything, you know what I'm saying? You're doing all you can. And even if you're not working, you're just doing all you can. So anyway, I'm sleeping in a car for like 6 months and I'm getting up 4 o'clock in the morning, going to work, getting off at 4 in the afternoon, going back. I'm talking about spending the night at the job. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about like working 12 hours, like overnight. And I was going through this journey where I was like separated from everybody. I'm talking about, you know, people. I knew people that can help me, but I couldn't get to them. People were stretching out their hand, doing everything they could for me, but the help just didn't manifest. So whatever it was meant for me to go through that journey. I'm not saying that, you know, certain people, like I say, certain people are going to go through things to be that testimony. They're going to get through it. But I guarantee you, those 6 months of sleeping in that car, going to work every day, people not even knowing it, making videos in the gym, praying while I'm driving on the freeway 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. People didn't really know. But I'm gonna tell you why they didn't know. Because when you going through something like that, when you going through that journey, it's like some angels are carrying you through the journey. I'm telling you, I felt days when I would go to the beach and I would just be up there. Sometimes it was hot, but I'm telling you, it felt like God was right there holding my hand the whole time. I don't know who that's for, but you know who it's for. Nobody knew it. You know, those days you're sleeping out in the car and things are not going your way. But it's magical how comfortable God creates the being in that process. Now, don't get me wrong, you know, being homeless is no fun or going through a trial or something. I lived by myself for 5 years. Before that happened, I just decided to just move and thought some things would work better on the other end. It didn't quite work out the way I had planned it. So I said, I'll do better alone. So we making these videos, I'm getting the better angles and stuff like that. You know, we getting better at it and it's going to grow. I ask you guys to go to YouTube and subscribe for me. You know what I mean? Look out for the book. I'm writing this joint. I just hope, you know, it's taking a minute, but it's worth it. You know what I'm saying? This is your boy, Elijah Efron. Peace and blessings to you, love. Keep the love going. We out.